Gato Perro back with another video, and in the middle of the ring, we got the WWE Classic Superstars 2-pack, Mankind versus The Undertaker. Alright, so, the timing on this is impeccable. It seems that Undertaker's retired, unfortunately, based off his last episode of The Last Ride. Regardless of that, I got lots of figures. My fandom continues on, for he is my favorite wrestler of all time. And I got plenty of figures to talk about, and this one is one that I've really been looking forward to and I got recently. I'm guessing this depicts their match at Hell in a Cell. But we'll see, because that table is a little weird. I don't remember them using a table ever, but I don't really like to complain about accessories because they're all cool. Mankind vs. Undertaker on the side, a picture of the prototypes on the side. And we got the same thing on the back with stats, debuts, finishers, weights, and all that good stuff, as well as other figures from the Classic Superstar series. In all honesty, I'd really hate to rip open this package because it looks so pristine, but I can't help it. I'm not a men on card collector. I like having them out and recreating all those memorable moments. So let's take a look at Mankind versus The Undertaker. So I've done as much research as I possibly could prior to me shooting this video, primarily on just figuring out exactly how accurate these two figures are, specifically The Undertaker, to that Hell in a Cell match. And going back, it seems this figure is a lot more accurate than I thought it was. Originally, I thought that he had a missing amount of decals on his shirt. Primarily, The Undertaker usually wears black shirts, like always, but they have designs across the chest, like straps, and they have like crosses, or they're either X's. This particular figure, different to the 3-pack Undertaker, it actually does have the X designs on the sides, and apparently it turns out that the shirt he was wearing on that night was a plain thin black shirt with no designs at all, and for some reason on that night he wore that shirt, and you can see it almost completely came off. It was tattered almost to the middle. It turns out this Undertaker is super detailed in that regard. As close as it can get with a Jax figure. Mankind, definitely looks accurate. He had that the white wrist tape, the black boots, trademark look for Mankind. This is a really cool set. Well, we'll talk about accessories first. We do get this breakaway table that we've all seen before, and actually it's a lot of fun, and it's never really lost its fun factor. Of course, you can break anyone through it. You can fold it all back up, put it back together, and make your best JR impression. So this is my first time owning a Mankind figure. Previously, I've only owned the Mick Foley, but I've never really had many Mankinds, and I've skipped over the Mattel ones, specifically the one that was a SummerSlam Elite. No real particular reason. I don't know why. Maybe it didn't suit me, but for some reason, this figure is really cool to me. Of course, I can admit that some of the proportions are very exaggerated, and you know, Mankind has never really had overly buff arms or anything of the sort like that. But for the time, I think Jax did a really cool job with this, and I can't deny that the head sculpt is probably like the most impressive thing about this figure. Just the smile that he has, the missing teeth, the tongue, it's a really cool look, specifically for recreating that part of the match when he's in the corner, and it looks like he's smiling, but I think it's because first of all, his tooth was in his nose, and I think he had a gap in his lip is the reason why he was smiling. You can see the mask is really nicely detailed. It does have silver studs around the sides. And much like other Jet Mankind figures, I was going to call him McFoley, you can take off the mask, which I think is a really cool feature. Specifically, since this is based off his look from the Hell in a Cell match, at the later half of the match, after he gets thrown off, he's no longer wearing the mask. So particularly with this one, I thought there was going to be some kind of weird smudging on the shirt since it's all white. There is some on the back a little bit. But it's not a crazy amount, and it doesn't seem like there's anywhere to unstrap or unbutton the shirt. It is one piece. These kind of look like shoulder pads, but they're supposed to represent sleeves, and that's very inaccurate, and I wish Jax would have come up with a better way of bringing that into figure form. But nevertheless, it's still not a really bad look, and it does have the tatters on the side, and then the tie is one piece that is all connected onto the shirt itself, so you can't really lift it up or anything. And if you look underneath, he does have a little bit of a belly, so he is using a big body mold. Standard tights for the bottom and big boots on the bottom. So interesting fact about this Undertaker, this head sculpt originally was used for Biker Taker back during the Titantron series figures. I'm pretty sure I saw this head sculpt on one of the figures that came in a pack that also came in with a ring. But back then he had more of his regular redhead hair. So this one's, I think this is the only one I know of where he has the black long hair with this particular look. And I think it's really cool. It definitely looks young. I like the detail of the teeth. It's very different. I love how the hair flows down the back. You can see strands. You can even follow individual hairs to their point of origin. So I think that's pretty cool. I was talking about how this particular Undertaker, based on the Night of Hell Cell, was actually pretty accurate. Of course, Jax does have repetitive body molds. And for what they have, this shirt mold is actually does fit the build really well. Only inaccuracy I can find is that he does have the Sarah tattoo on his neck, which I don't think he had at the time. I did look at pictures, and I don't think he got that until he came back as Biker Taker. As per weird and usual, he does have his green tattoos with the bunnies on his bicep. But then he does have two elbow pads, which he did have on that night. And here are the details of the little X's on the side of his tights. This particular time, they did decide to include knee pads, which aren't really present or that quite visible. They're mostly underneath his tights on Taker in real life, but I'll take them and I'll keep them on because his boots, I feel like, are a little short. I feel like they should be a little taller, but I do like how they went with the mold with the laces. Here he is next to his twin. This is the Undertaker from the 3-pack with Bearer and Kane. I recently reviewed that, so if you haven't seen it, check it out if you are interested, basically. So yeah, as you can see, these guys are very similar. Little small differences here and there. Namely, the head sculpt. I think this guy has a little bit of a bigger head. Of course, this is his 1999 look, more of his ministry. And the only other difference are basically the hands. His left side is an open grip. And as well as from the knees down, he does have a different boot mold. So I love both of these figures. They are basically the same, but those little small differences really do make a big difference to me, at least, of being a big fan of Taker. So that's my short, simple review on this very amazing 2-pack. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I am basically going to be talking about a lot of Jax in the future. I found myself recently very inspired by the Major Wrestling Figure Podcast and a guy named Kyle Peterson. Who knows if he'll ever watch these videos. But essentially, I'm going on a big nostalgia trip, and I'm buying up a lot of Jax figures. Things I couldn't buy before because I was too young, didn't have money. So I didn't know they existed. But hopefully you guys can join me on this quest and of reviews, because I feel like a lot of overall interest and, you know, times have changed. Obviously, the big companies come, you know, Jazzwares and currently Mattel are the talk of the town, wrestling figure-wise. But these figures, Jack's figures, Jack specific Ruthless Aggression style figures, will always have a special place in my heart. Of course, Deluxe Aggression, but overall the Jack's wrestling line. So I want to talk about a lot of those. I got a lot of reviews coming up, so hopefully you guys will join me. I got lots of classic superstars, a lot of Ruthless Aggression, a lot of Adrenaline 2-packs, stuff like that. So yeah, highly recommend these figures. They're a little bit expensive. They go up to 150 and higher, so you know, tread carefully, but they're definitely worth it. Thank you for watching. Gato Perro!